the Quran was complete. It was compiled in the supervision of the Prophet himself. He himself supervised. The Quran, alhamdulillah, was complete. And there is no difference of opinion as far as the Quran is concerned. But the Prophet did not encourage to write down the hadiths, his sayings, lest it would get mixed up. Later on, after his death, when people started saying things in the name of the Prophet, which he did not say, then the people thought, fine, now we should check up whether did the Prophet say this or not. So the compilation of the hadith started after the death of the Prophet. And during the time of these great Aimmas, Imam Abu Hanifa, Imam Malik, Imam Shafi, Imam Ahmad bin Imam Hanbal, may Allah's mercy be on all of them, it was yet continuing. It wasn't completed. Later on, Imam Bukhari came, then Imam Muslim came, Abu Dawood, Tirmidhi, and then later on, after the demise of the four great Aimmas, the process was more formulated. So therefore, based on whatever was the knowledge they had, they gave the opinion. Somebody will ask me, Brother Zakir, do you think you're more intelligent than Abu Hanifa? Brother Zakir, do you think you're more intelligent than Imam Shafi? May Allah's mercy be on both of them. I said no. Nothing. Compared to them, we are nothing. They were far closer to the Prophet. The knowledge, mashallah. The iman, we cannot compare. No one living now can compare to them. But we have to realize, as I mentioned, that the process of compilation of the hadith was going on. So all the four Aimmah said, no Muslim can say that he knows all the Sahih hadith. So because today is the age of science and technology. Now if today, at that time, during the Aimmahs, if you want to collect a hadith, you had to travel hundreds of kilometers, thousands of kilometers. You had to write down, there was no Xerox machine. Today, Xerox is there, fax is there, email is there. From this end of the world to America, you can fax. You can send my email. Within seconds, it reaches there. That time, science and technology had not advanced. Today, if you want all the Sahih hadith, you can have on a disc. The complete Bukhari, you can have on a disc. Bukhari, Muslim, in IRF, 1 million hadith on one disc. Classified, Sahih, Zaif, Maudu. So today, because of science and technology advanced, the access for us to the hadith is much more easier as compared to these great scholars. For example, today, if a student who passes BSc, Bachelor of Science, in terms of scientific knowledge, he may have more knowledge than Isaac Newton. Isaac Newton happens to be the best scientist of humanity. You know, Isaac Newton, number one. Michael H. Hart, when he wrote a book, The 100 Most Influential Men in History, he places our beloved Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam number one. Number two, Isaac Newton. But if someone comes and asks me, suppose your son has passed his BSc, or if you have passed your BSc, if someone tells, are you more intelligent than Isaac Newton? See, you may know many things which Isaac Newton did not know. But in terms of science and technology, what brain Isaac Newton had, even the Nobel Prize winner of science doesn't have. Isaac Newton had an intelligent brain. Depending upon the limited resources he had, the amount of advances he made in science is phenomenal. Therefore, he's called one of the best scientists of humankind. But today, a person who has passed BSc, overall, may have more knowledge than Isaac Newton. He knows all the laws of Newton. He even has corrected the mistake of Newton. Not he has not corrected. By the time other scientists have come, they have corrected the mistakes of Newton. So a person who has passed BSc overall may have more access to scientific knowledge than Isaac Newton. But that does not make him a greater scientist than Isaac Newton. Similarly, today when we can analyze the hadith easily because of these great scholars, Imam Bukhari, Imam Muslim, and the other scholars right down till this age, it is easier for us to know whether the hadith is sahih or not, and easy because of science and technology. That does not mean we are more superior to these Aimmas. We are more intelligent. No, not at all. I cannot claim that, and no one should claim that. Not that we are more intelligent, we are more knowledgeable. Today, because of science and technology, the knowledge is much more easily accessible. So let me clear that point very clearly. Therefore, I said the topic is sensitive. We respect all these four Aimmas. They were great scholars. And the solution for the unity of the Muslim Ummah lies in the ayat I started my talk with. Allah says in Surah Al-Imran, chapter number 3, verse number 103, وَاتَثِيمُوا بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا وَلَا تَفَرَّقُوا. Hold to the rope of Allah strongly and be not divided. Which is the rope of Allah? The rope of Allah is the glorious Quran. Allah says, hold strongly to the rope of Allah and be not divided. وَاتَثِيمُوا بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا وَلَا تَفَرَّقُوا. Hold together strongly to the rope of Allah and be not divided. Be together and be not divided. Double emphasis. Double emphasis. And the Quran says in several places, Atullah wa Atul Rasul. Obey Allah and obey the Messenger. Allah gives this commandment to the Muslims in several places, in no less than 20. In more than 20 verses of the Quran, the Allah says, Atullah wa Atul Rasul. In Surah Al-Imran, chapter number 3, verse number 32. In Surah Al-Imran, chapter number 3, verse number 132. In Surah Nisa, chapter number 4, verse number 13. In Surah Nisa, chapter number 4, verse number 59. In Surah Nisa, chapter number 4, verse number 69. In Surah Nisa, chapter number 4, verse number 80. In Surah Maida, chapter number 5, verse number 92. In Surah Anfal, chapter number 8, verse number 1. In Surah Anfal, chapter number 8, verse number 20. In Surah Anfal, chapter number 8, verse number 46. In Surah Tawbah, chapter number 9, verse number 71. In Surah Nur, chapter number 24, verse number 47. In Surah Nur, chapter number 24, verse number 52. In Surah Nur, chapter number 24, verse number 54. In Surah Azab, chapter number 33, verse number 31. In Surah Azab, chapter 33, verse number 33. In Surah Muhammad, chapter number 47, verse number 33. In Surah Fatah, chapter number 48, verse number 17. In Surah Hujurat, chapter number 49, verse number 14. In Surah Mujadila, chapter number 58, verse number 13. In Surah Taghabun, chapter number 64, verse number 12. In more than 20 verses of the Quran, Allah says, Atiullah wa Atiur Rasul. Obey Allah and obey the Messenger. The rope of Allah is the glorious Quran and the authentic hadith of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allah tells us clearly, hold together fast to the rope of Allah and be not divided, to the Quran and the Sahih hadith. Allah says in the Quran, in Surah Anam, chapter number 6, verse number 159, Allah says that as to those who divide the religion and break it into sects, thou has nothing to do with them. Telling the Prophet, thou has nothing to do with them. Their affairs is with Allah. All their affairs is with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah will tell them what is the truth. Allah tells the Prophet, as to those who divide the religion and break it into sects, O Prophet, thou has nothing to do with them. All their affairs is with Allah. And Allah will tell them what is the truth. That means making sex in the religion of Islam is haram. It is prohibited. And this has been mentioned in several places in the Quran. Allah repeats this message in Surah Rum, chapter number 30, verse number 31 and 32. It says that be not like those who associate partners with Allah, and like those who divide the religion and make it into mere sects, and each one rejoicing that they are on the truth. Allah says in Surah Rum, chapter 30, verse 31 and 32, that be not like those who associate partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and like those